Forecaster Jada Russell with us once again. Jada, you mentioned some above average temperatures for the rest of the weekend.
That's right. We are starting to see temperatures fall into the lower 70s for most of us around here. We're seeing 72 here in Savannah, and that's the name of the game across the coastal areas. But as we move inland, we're seeing 73 from Statesboro, Metter, Reidsville, and Vidalia, 71 for Hinesville and Greenville, Glenville. So that's what we're continuing to see for the rest of the night. And that'll be the name of the game for the next couple of days. Clear conditions so far. We did see a pop-up shower or two right around Hinesville and Alma and Blackshear. But for the most part, rather clear. And that'll be, again, the name of the game for the rest of the week until we get to the latter half of our week. And I'll go over that in just a moment. So what we're seeing for the 12 hours, once again, 7 a.m., it starts quite brisk, 69 degrees as you walk out the door. Bit of a breeze out there as well, so light jacket may be needed as you go through your morning for church. But as we continue to look through the day, we get to around 90 degrees at 3 p.m. So it's going to be a warm afternoon, especially because it's technically the first day of fall. By that point, 8:43 a.m. on Sunday is when it officially begins for fall, but we are nowhere near the average high that we typically sit at right around this time of year. 85 degrees, and like I said, 90s are high for tomorrow. We are over by 5 whopping degrees. So it's going to be a warmer day out there. Not quite fall just yet. I promise we'll get there, but seems to be sticking around with that heat. So what we're seeing for the tropics right now, a broad scale look here. We're seeing two disturbances in the Atlantic Basin right now. They don't seem to be moving into any islands or any land areas to affect anyone. But our biggest concern is our Gulf disturbance. We're starting to see these models finally get a little bit of consistency, moving it further into the Gulf. But as we look with the GFS, we're starting to see that move further east. And this model in particular does show that we may see some impacts here in Georgia. Now, what we are expecting for that is about the 25th through the 28th of this week. So the latter half of this week is when we'll expect to see any kind of impact from that. Now, looking at our 10-day, once again, Sunday is the first official day of fall, starting right around 8:43 a.m. specifically, but we start to finally dip into those mid to lower 80s right around Wednesday. The first chance of rain pops up that day as well. But look, as we get into the back half of the week, into the weekend, it's going to be rain chances every single day, as you can see there, and we're going to continue to see that throughout the back half of the week. Same for our coastal communities. Wednesday will be the first day of rain, and we'll continue to see it follow through for the following week. Over to you guys at the desk.